Hello awesome people of YouTube, welcome back to another game of Starcraft 2. This is going to be LotV Snute versus his opponent FireCake. Now just very quickly, FireCake is on Team Euronics Gaming and LotV Snute is on Team Liquid, of course. So this is going to be game number 3. This is a best of 5. It's the quarterfinal of the HomeStory Cup. I am absolutely stoked to go on to the final, which is actually after this game. And you might already know who exactly is going towards it. You might have seen the tournament before already. I hope you haven't and that nothing is spoiled here so far. Of course, don't leave any spoilers in the comments. That would absolutely not be appreciated. And I will delete your comment to try to avoid any spoilers for anybody else. So, looks like both players scouting out in the wrong direction. Of course, they are all the way across from each other. There is a extractor trick going down here for FireCake, for Snute even. And he seems to... No, sorry, it was FireCake, I think, that was pretty fond of it before. So, quite strange to see this from here. Now, there is a spawning pool going down for actually both players. So, this is very interesting. They played with a hatchery first for 2 games in a row. They were playing very, very... I'm air quoting as if you can see... you know, honorably, without an early expansion, or sorry, with an early expansion, without early early pool, but here, they do opt to get the early lings. And it does look like Snute's lings are actually a lot earlier, so that's definitely something to note. He is going to have gas already on the way for the metabolic boost, so this could potentially be a very, very quick game. The question is, of course, going to be, how fast will these players find each other? At this point, FireCake knows that it's one of 2 bases. Snute has not yet scouted any base yet. He's probably going to send these lings all the way straight across, which... Oh, is he not doing that? He is actually sending them split. So one going to the bottom left and one going straight to the correct base. Going to try to catch out the correct base, hopefully, before the metabolic boost comes out. His metabolic boost, by the way, is a lot earlier, just to mention that. And he does not have a hatchery on the way, so he's definitely trying to do a lot of early aggression to force the GG out of FireCake. And just a note, of course, if you haven't seen the previous games, you should have clicked the annotations at the start. It might be a little bit late now, they're probably gone by now, so do go back. But at the moment, it is a 2-0. And I will not spoil the... game at all for you, but looks like a lot of aggression going on here. There is 2 banelings here also doing a little bit of damage, trying to catch any sort of reinforcing lings. And are they gonna pop? Yes, 2 get popped here, and at the moment it does look like LotV Snute still coming out on top here. So it looks like 2 more banelings are on the way as well. It is getting very, very dangerous. He needs to do more damage right now before reinforcements comes out. If there's going to be a Roachborn coming up, which there actually isn't, then he would eventually lose this very quickly. Most likely, actually. Does look like he decides to sacrifice a Baneling on the hatchery, which wasn't entirely necessary, but looks like there we go. He's FireKick making more and more Zerglings at the moment, trying to basically produce enough to hold off this attack. That's exactly what he needs to do, because after that, at that point, LotV Snute will not really have that much to follow up with. There is a hatchery coming down, but it's a very, very late hatchery. He already knows at this point that if he manages to do enough damage to this base and force, you know, banelings and potentially even roaches out, either he is going to do enough damage or it'll be a little bit too late for him and he will lose out. So he's trying to macro up a little bit, seeing what he can pull off. Bringing this one Zergling towards the Baneling. It's going to start doing damage. It's definitely worth trading one Baneling for a Zergling, because of course a Baneling costs additional gas and I believe minerals as well. It's like 25-25. Deciding to back on out, not going for the all in, and it does look like FireCake has survived this round. So very, very good play here from FireCake, not deciding to send Lings in 2x2, which of course a lot of us may try to do when we're being rushed, just to defend the base, holding off a little bit, losing the hatchery, which unfortunately did put him a little bit behind. But he is going to be in a good position to come back right now. Does have his own Banelings, there's 4 of them right here, and actually a 5th one heading on back, not sure why. He also has a slightly superior number of Zerglings as well. Oh my god, look at the amount of Banelings here. This could be quite significant. There's a huge amount of banelings being morphed in here. Gonna see a few explosions here. Boom! One goes explode. Not deciding to bring them into those three banelings. That could potentially take all three out. But there we go. Huge damage being taken here. Now, just note that Liquid Snute has his base already completed and fully saturated. So it's going to really depend on how many lings he's going to hit with these banelings. If he manages to take them all out, oh my god, the massive banelings here. So much damage being done to these drones. Absolutely insane. Now decides to bring these back in, bring them to work. A few being transferred here as well because they're getting cleaned up by Firecake. So Firecake doing extremely well here right now considering he did get rushed. He destroys 14 drones. So not only did Snute start off with less drones because of the rush, he's also lost 14 after that. Now there is roaches here for Snute as well, so just to note, they do counter pretty much everything that Firecake has at the moment, but the numbers of Firecake Zerglings and no longer Banelings is quite huge. So these Zerglings now inside the middle line, I do believe they're going to be able to clean all this up, and GG is called by Liquid Snute. This brings the series 2-1, and very, very well held off by Firecake here. So there you go, exactly as I said, when you are rushing with an early pool and early banelings, you're either going to win right there and then. If the opponent decides to hold out and manages to hold out, at that point you're pretty much done. If he counters attacks, he does have better economy and better force, and that's pretty much it. So a 2-1 in favor of Snute. Still, we're going to move on to game number 4 pretty much straight away right now, and hopefully we're going to see a game number 5 straight after that. So I'll see you guys in the next video. Good luck, have fun, and please leave that video a thumbs up if you think it deserves it. Bye-bye.